So we can use flowcharts to express data flow through a program. So again, going back to our cup of tea program, we can express it as a flowchart like this. We start with the symbols here. So I've just put here what the symbols mean within our flowchart. Okay, so we start with a start, which is this kind of rounded style rectangle almost. Okay, and this just signifies the start of our program. Okay, we can then use an arrow, which shows progress of the data through our flowchart. So we'll go there. And the first thing we want to do is fill the kettle. Now, filling the kettle is a process. Okay, a process. So it's a thing that happens in the program. Okay, that's what a process is. So if I draw a rectangle, that's a really bad rectangle, and fill kettle. I'll do my best to squeeze my writing in here. And then we go down to the next part of the program, which is another process. Boil the water. Okay. And then we go down to the next part of the program, which is get our cup and tea bag. Cup plus tea bag. Okay. And then we go to our next part of the process, which is a boil the water. And what we can do for this is boil the water for 2 minutes. So we could make this a decision box. Okay. So boil water 2 minutes. Okay, so is the 2 minutes up? If it's not, we send our arrow back here. If it is, if the 2 minutes is up, then we send our arrow onto the next process, which is take tea bag out. Okay. Out. There we go. And then add milk. So again, this can be another decision. I'm not quite sure I'm going to squeeze this in. What I'll do, I think, is we'll just move on to the next part up here. Okay. And we'll put a decision up here. Oh dear, that's not the greatest diamond ever. So add milk until happy with the colour. So if we are happy, we'll go on to the next part of the program. If we're not happy, we'll just join background and keep adding the milk. Okay, but if we are happy, we want the last part of our process is drink tea. Okay, and then we'll finish with a stop. Okay, so if you remember, the start and end is this symbol up here. So we'll finish with a sort of curvy rectangle and write stop. Okay, it's just so we know that this is the start of the program, this is the end of the program. Okay, the only thing we've missed there really is an input. Okay, so I suppose we could have had that up here. So we could have had an input add milk if we were kind of thinking about this a bit more carefully. But an input is normally where a user has to put something into the program, maybe a command like yes, no, something along those lines. Okay, but what we've essentially got here is a flowchart with pretty bad handwriting for making a cup of tea.